It was 2050, almost 200 years since Bertha had perished in the fire. But Jacqueline wanted to know more. There will be one book, her teacher had told her. One book that will affect you. And when you find it... Jacqueline had traced them all, from Ophelia, born in 1966, her grandmother, to Ophelia's father, Edmund, born in 1936, to John, his father, born in 1900, to Bertha's first grandchild, born in 1880. None of them had interested her, except Bertha. Here they were in 2050 with all this reversal, no cars. They were piled in heaps, large heaps, everywhere. People flew light aircrafts, circular flying machines with rubber bumpers in case of collision, but too high up to bother anyone. The rest of them were quite content to travel in the old style, by horse and carriage, and since clothes couldn't be made cheaply anymore, to wear the same gown all week. When Jacqueline discovers Bertha's journal during the rebuilding of Thornfield Hall, she knows that this is the one book that will affect her. Jacqueline and her husband, Harry, read of Bertha's struggle to find her identity and her version of the events that led to the fire at Thornfield Hall, all of which is having a strange effect upon Jacqueline. Thornfield Hall possesses a history that increasingly threatens the couple's new married life. What secrets did a dead ancestor bury in her book? Inspired by Charlotte Bronte's Jane Eyre, Jean Rhys's Wide Sargasso Sea, Joseph Conrad's Heart of Darkness, and Virginia Woolf's Mrs. Dalloway, Bertha's Journal is an inventive narrative that yields an intriguing look at one of literature's most fascinating characters. Bertha's Journal, A Perfect Immelman Turn, is available on Amazon.com and other online retailers, as well as directly from the publisher.